Today on the Stay at Home Chef, I'm showing you how to make braided pumpkin bread. This isn't your typical pumpkin bread. Most pumpkin breads are quick breads, but this is a yeast-based bread. The pumpkin flavor isn't super strong. In fact, it's very mild. The bread really just tastes like fall. It's so soft and delicious. It's actually one of our family's favorite breads. My kids are super excited that I'm making this today. It starts with 2.5 teaspoons of instant dry yeast. And you want to make sure you use instant because it requires no proofing and you can just move on with your recipe. I'm going to put that in my stand mixer along with 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, 2 tablespoons of warm water that's just warm to the touch, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 cup of softened butter, 1 cup of pumpkin puree, and that's just from a can. Just make sure you have pumpkin puree and not pumpkin pie mix. 2 very different things. Then we're gonna add in 1 egg and 1/3 cup of warm milk. And I just warmed that in the microwave for about 20 seconds. And then we'll add in 3.5 cups of all-purpose flour. You may end up adding up to 4 cups of flour in this recipe, but we're gonna start with 3.5 and get this mixing. The dough should pull away from the sides of the bowl and form a dough ball just like this. If not, you may need to add a little bit more flour. It should take about 3 or 4 minutes to get your dough where it needs to be. Then we're gonna pull it out and transfer it to a lightly greased mixing bowl. Cover it with a towel and let it rise until double in size, which will take about 1 hour. Once the dough has risen, turn it out onto a clean, flat work surface and divide it into 3 somewhat equal pieces. And I just eyeball it on size. Then we're gonna take each of these pieces and roll them into ropes or snakes. You want each one to be about 18 inches long. Once you've rolled all your pieces out, it's time to braid them together. And this is the part I love because it makes the bread so pretty. Lay them all side by side like so, and then take one end and pinch all the pieces together. Then you just braid it back and forth, just like you would with hair. And then pinch the end together. And then I'm gonna gently lift this up and place it onto a lightly greased baking sheet. Super, super easy. I'm gonna cover this with my towel again and let it rise for another 30 minutes while I get the oven preheating to 350 degrees. Once it's risen the second time, take a lightly beaten egg and brush it over the top of the loaf. The egg will give the bread a nice shine to it that makes it even prettier. Next, we're gonna take this and bake it in the 350 degree oven for 25 minutes. And that's it. Once your bread has finished baking, simply transfer it to a wire rack to cool completely. Thanks for watching. You can find the full written recipe in the video description. Be sure to subscribe and check out the rest of my channel where you can find hundreds of restaurant quality recipes you can easily make at home. See you later.